Welcome to Drop the Puck. In this episode, we're going to feature a Model League conference battle between the Solway Sharks and Blackburn Hawks.
Yeah, Gary, really good matchup there tonight. Obviously, the Blackburn Hawks, the champs of yesteryear, shall we say.
Yeah.
And now, of course, the new Solway Sharks champs.
Yeah, Solway Sharks, current champions for this year. But they're up against the really, really tough Blackburn Hawks, coming off the back of a great win last night at Billingham Stars, the number two ranked team. So they find their form a little bit of old. Hopefully they can make it pay. They need the points all really, really badly at the moment because they need to pull themselves further away from that relegation battle that's happening down at the bottom there. It's tying a lot of teams in. And Blackburn, hopefully, are making paces towards a possible playoff spot. But of course, players to watch out for tonight, Ben.
Well, of course, we're talking about Blackburn, and there's only one name that jumps to mind for me, and that is the import they brought in towards mid of the season, Joseph Astocci. He found his form a couple of games in for Blackburn, and he hasn't really stopped scoring. He's very lethal, given, you know, any sort of time on the puck, especially in those point areas. Get him in front of the paint, you know, he's stabbing away, he's putting them there as well. But of course, Gary's always got a partner in crime on the ice.
Rick Bentham, of course. Rick has been a pivotal player in this season, as has Aaron Davis, of course. But you can't take it away from any of the Hawk players. They seem to have found that gel they've needed for this season, which was eluding them earlier on and wasn't giving them the results they wanted. Hopefully, they'll find what they need. Of course, don't forget, we're going to be watching out for Solway Shark Stars, sorry to say that, Steve Moore, of course, their top scorer, and of course, there's others like Abercrombie and Coulter we've been looking out for as well. So with that, we're going to hand over to our two commentators tonight at the Blackburn Ice Arena, and that's Brian Shuttleworth and Oz Phillips.
As Mr. Farron, our official for the evening, gets ready to drop the opening puck. As that face-off is won straight away off the bat by the Blackburn Hawks, back to Duncombe. He plays over to Oliver and then back to him, and now Oliver once again. Oliver gets it into the middle of the ice and through neutral zone as he dumps that straight on Chris Ray, gets an early glove on that and holds for a whistle immediately.
Yeah, the Hawks are just marking the territory, you know. Get a few shots on the keeper to begin with before he's maybe warmed up, before he's got his head into this game. Because, of course, he hasn't had a lot of ice time for the Sharks this season. And he may not be used to playing at this level either. You know, potentially, if you're going to score a quick goal on a netminder, you can keep his head out of the game for the rest of the 60 minutes.
Is that face-off tied up in the Sharks' end? Won by the Sharks eventually as that's fired around the boards and just batted straight back to neutral ice by Coulter as it's picked up by Nick Oliver. He dances around a check and drops it for Searman. He's going to throw it to the far corner. James Royds is going to chase there and get there too as he cycles that around, but only Stuart Kerr is able to get hold of it. Played behind once again, but now picked up by Bentham. Played out in front, goes off a skate and just off the pad of Chris Ray, who had no idea that was coming, as the Sharks fire that all the way down the ice, and it will be icing.
That's something that we don't see a lot from the Sharks. That's an icing call against them. They're normally very methodical, very calm from the back, and they would have played that puck out. So to whack it away in such a way, okay, running in the first minute of the game, but we expect more from their defence than just to ice it in that situation.
Absolutely. So we have a face-off on the Hawks' left wing in the Sharks' end. Of course, Chris Ray's right. As that face-off is won by the Sharks, Stuart Kerr on possession as he throws that behind to be collected by Senko, and he plays forwards now for Coulter. Coulter down this right-hand side through the neutral zone, plays it towards the middle as that's picked up, dropped back into the middle by Spears, unable to be collected by anyone other than James Royds as he tries to clear, kept in at the point by Kerr. Kerr now cycling it back down again for Spears. Spears now circling top of the circle, shoots, blocked into the corner by Stu Ashton, and that will be collected by Royds. Plenty of time and space for him as he takes that to neutralise calmly, and it gets a massive hit on him as he loses out of possession, and now Kim Mietnen coming forwards. Mietnen skating through the middle, using good strength to try and get a pass through. Bounces off a skate though, and now picked up by Istocci down this left-hand side. Istocci's going to throw that behind the goal, collected with a quick shot, just flashes across the crease of Ray again. Had no idea that was coming, as Lewis Baldwin cycles that around now for Aaron Davis on this right-hand side. He throws it behind as there's no Hawks there. It will be kept in at the left half-boards by James Riddick, as now he's checked, and it's picked up by Buesa. As he looks to work a way out, only gets to Istocci, and now played back down low again for Aaron Davis, and now Istocci once again across the middle, just missing the stick of Riddick. A slap shot fanned by Chris G, as the Sharks again fire that all the way down the ice, and no one's there to get there quick enough as two Sharks players are getting there. Stevie Moore on the puck now, just dispossessed by Lewis Baldwin as he rings that around the boards and right back to neutralise to be collected by Statusfield. Statusfield forward now for Buesa on this right hand side. He'll throw deep as the Sharks will go for a wholesale line change. Picked up by Chris G in his own end. He plays it across for Lewis Baldwin now. Forwards tipped off the stick of Corey Stones. That'll be collected almost by Mulcahy as the Sharks get possession, batted again, straight back to neutral ice and lose out as it bounces around a little. And Phil Mulcahy is going to have a good chance here as it gets played into the Sharks' end by one of their own players. He's got it in the corner now. Cuts back at the halfway. It's being checked and tracked well, though, by the Sharks. Comes back to the point for Sanderson. Now played behind, another quick pass goes in front, just missed the stick of Stones as that's cut out by the Sharks, and now they look to come back the other way. Carried forwards now by Kieran Hare. He plays it back towards the half boards, but it only comes to the Hawks as now this is carried forward, and a quick shot goes in from, I believe, Corey Stones as that circles around the boards, kept in by Price, and now Corey Stones again, dispossessed though this time by Senko as he plays it forwards. Now played across for Senko once again through the middle. Gets over the blue line, tries a toe drag. It works out, but he just pulls back and fires a quick shot that's gloved by Stu Ashton. 14 minutes and 14 seconds left here in the first as the Sharks win that face-off. Ringing around the boards now for Struan Tonar. He's checked behind the goal as that's picked up by Bentham and tried to clear. And now played all the way across towards Mikko Searman. He can't get on the end of it though. Stuart Kerr is alert. As Searman again tips that forward into the Sharks' end. Not picked up by a Hawks player as the Sharks fire that all the way back for Steve Duncombe to collect. He bounces off the boards as it's tipped forwards into the zone for Bentham now on this right-hand side. Fires it all the way to the middle as it goes all the way to neutralise and picked up now by Tonar. Tonar, poke check on him, gets the Hawks' possession back as now it's played forward again for Bentham. Bentham with a slap shot just off the leg of Steve Moore, and that did a bit of damage as Senko blows a tyre out behind, and the Hawks get hold of possession before he recovers and gets hold of the puck and circles back into his end as both teams are going to go for a big line change here.
So I was just looking there. We have the physio of the Solway Sharks racing around. That's Hazel Mayer. Not quite sure what's happened, but there may be a player with an issue on the bench for the Sharks.
This is Fowley now. He drops it back to Kim Mietnen on the point. Now all the way across for Andrews. Top of the circle. Shoots over the net. And it bounces into the corner. Collected now by Aaron Davis. Aaron Davis skating down this right-hand side. Three men in front of him, so he just hammers a slap shot off the glass picked up by Stocci, and he cycles it back round for Davis once again. Plays it across to the middle. Just missed the stick of James Riddick in front, as he would have had a golden chance there. Picked up by Lewis Baldwin now on the right-hand side. Sorry, no, it's... actually, I can't tell from here. It might be Sanderson. It's Stocci in the middle. Scores! As he gathers a bouncing puck behind, carries it to the middle where he had no right to skate, and tucks it past the pad of Chris Ray.
That was a good goal. Not a great goal, it was a good goal. Well worked by the Hawks. He brought it into the area and he took a shot into the corner, but that went across the body of the netminder, Chris Ray. He should have put a bit more of a leg out on that one. I feel another netminder could have actually saved that. But it's a goal for the Hawks. As I said, I feel that they may win this game. 1-0 up in the first 8 minutes. It's good progressing signs for them.
Indeed, as it is 1-0 Blackburn now after that goal by Joseph Istocci with 12:34 left here in the first. As that opening face-off after the goal is won by the Sharks. Played back for Statusfield as he plays that. Bounces off the shelf, though, of the glass, but it will be collected by Fowley and now played for Spears, who hammers into the far corner. Collected by Coulter now on this right-hand side. He plays it behind again for Spears. Back in front towards Coulter. He can't get the shot away as it's tipped out of the Hawks zone, and two Hawks players race onto that to try and get possession and move forwards. Istocci, though, playing it back now for Chris G as that's tipped forwards, and now Aaron Davis will look to get it. Duncan Spears, though, picks that pass off and drops back to his defenceman as he bounces off the glass all the way down the ice and back again for Chris G. G now plays it to Aaron Davis. His pass just off the mark towards James Riddick as that's picked up by Statusfield and now played forwards for Moore. Moore now into the Hawks end down the right-hand side. Cuts to the middle of the circle, shoots through a screen off a body and into the corner. Picked up again by Mulcahy as he just bats that out of the Hawks zone and clears. As that again is held up by the linesman on those boards, that is poor from him. He could have definitely got out of the way of that one. And the Sharks get possession in their own end. Played forwards now for Buesa down the right-hand side. Cuts the middle and takes a shot. Blocked well by Baldwin in front as he plays it back again now for Senko. Senko across to his defensive partner, but it's just tipped off his stick, so he has to play into the corner as Carl Price looks to clear. Kept in, though, with Corey Stones, and now back to Price. Tangled in his feet, though, and the Sharks get possession again. Good stick check, though, by Chris G to get hold of possession behind the goal. He's being pressured well by Abercrombie as he looks to work away forwards and does so now for Mulcahy. Mulcahy on the left-hand side, cuts to the middle, still in possession of the puck as Buesa almost dispossessed him. As it's picked up at the blue line, though, now by the Sharks and lofted forwards towards Buesa and only collected by Streetley. As this face-off won by the Sharks in their own end, to the left of Chris Reyes, it's picked up by Duncan Spears behind his own goal line. As he drops it now for Juraj Senko. As the Sharks now look to try and get into the Hawks' end with Fowley down this right-hand side. Just sticked away from him as the Hawks clear all the way down the ice. With just a minute and 10 left on the Sharks' power play now. Tonar playing that across to his defensive partner. And now carried forwards, chipped towards the middle. Backhand shot just goes wide as it's picked up now by Royds against the half boards. He can't clear as Senko with a shot. Rebound chance just sticked away as Bentham will fire that down the ice off the boards. And another good chance for the Sharks that they just missed out on.
Yeah, they're looking a lot more dangerous on their power play opportunity than the Hawks were on theirs. The way it's going at the minute with Kim Maitland coming forward, I can see the Sharks doing something on this one.
Just poke checked off Mietnan's stick, though, and out to neutralise as he looked a little dangerous there moving forwards. As there's 25 seconds left on this Sharks power play, carried into the zone by Stevie Moore as he gets it into the corner. Drops it back now for Senko. Sorry, Tonar even, as Stevie Moore now back towards the point. Tries a quick pass all the way across and just cut out by Royds as that's clear back to neutralise. Sharks throw that deep as that'll be picked up by Aaron Davis and he will clear once again back to neutral ice as the penalty ends and the Hawks kill off their penalty. But now Stevie Moore into the Hawks end, gets around his man, quick shot from a tight angle, held in the chest of Stuart Ashton.
Well played there by Stuart Ashton. Like I said, I thought the Sharks were going to get something from that because they did have the Hawks on the back foot from the 4-on-4 situation, the 20 seconds in between the two penalties. But as it is, it's still only 1-0 to the Hawks. Could go either way. The momentum hasn't really swung properly in this period.
1 minute 45 left in this period as the Sharks win that face off and a quick shot from the point from Juraj Senko through bodies. Again, held well by Stu Ashton.
The teams have just gone onto the ice / pool is the message that I've just got from Solihull. So that game is currently potentially going ahead at the moment. I think they'll see if it's playable. Obviously, if the puck sticks to that water, they aren't going to be playing much longer.
As another slap shot comes in off a body and goes behind, collected by Lewis Baldwin after the Sharks winning that face-off. Tied up, though, by two Sharks players, and now Istocci will go in and gather the puck and look to work a way out. Gets around Buesa, skating with good speed here as he gets into the Sharks' end. Drops it now for Aaron Davis with a shot. Couple bodies in front and a good save by Chris Ray. Baldwin now with another shot, tipped in front by Riddick and goes wide. Collected now by Istocci. Back again for Aaron Davis. Just tied up well, though, by Senko as the Sharks will barrel that back to neutral ice. And that was panic stations for them back in their own end then.
Ray was solid in goal, though. He was stood there. He was in the way. He was doing the right thing at the right time. A goal wasn't conceded, and that's his job at the end of the day.
As that's fired all the way down the ice. No icing as James Riddick gets there first. Picked up now by Istocci as he tries to get it to the middle. Istocci now just loses out of possession behind the Sharks' goal as they gather and look to clear. Poor pass, though, picked off by Riddick in the Sharks' end from Abercrombie. And now Istocci tied up against the board. Turns and gets around his man. Good chance here. Plays it for Riddick right into his skates, and he can't get a shot away as this is carried forward again for the Sharks now by Buesa. Cuts to the middle of the circle, can't get his shot away as it just barrels off his stick a little and fired all the way across the ice by Bentham for Aaron Davis with just 15 seconds left in the period. Bentham's going to look forwards now and try and get another quick shot. Goes off a leg and wide as Corey Stones gets there first. Plays it to the middle. Bentham unable to get a shot away. Still gets a stick on it. as he's barreled over. A quick shot comes in from Baldwin just over as Bentham dived to get out of the way of that one as it's back to neutral ice. And that is the end of the first period.
That just reminded me.
I've never seen anyone dive out of the way like that.
That reminded me of a scene from Happy Gilmore at the beginning when he's still an ice hockey player and he takes a shot and everyone moves out of the way and it hits the glass behind. Everyone knew what was going to happen then and they all just barreled out of the way. But no, as it is, 20 minutes of hockey, 1-0 to the Hawks. Still another 40 minutes to go, though. It's unfinished work for them, really.
As the face-off opening the second period, won by the Sharks back into their own end, bounce back to neutral ice as they look to try and work a way forwards. Picked off by Nick Oliver in his own end, though, as Coulter was chasing. And now play forwards by Duncombe. Misses the stick of Bentham, and Juraj Senko will collect in his own end. Circling, waiting for a passing option. Loses it off his stick as the ice surface is a little wet here still.
Yeah, it's still probably drier than what they're doing at Solihull, though.
Yeah, probably, as that's fouling now. It's just sticked off him by Royds as he gets his shot away, so it goes well wide. Fouling now again, though, down this right-hand side. Cuts around two men, gets to the middle, passes it instead of shooting, and unable to get a shot away. It was Coulter in front as the Hawks look to try and clear, as that bounces off a couple of bodies, still kept in at the blue line by the Sharks. Carried forwards now by Spears with a shot off the pad and into the corner. Rebound off him on the backhand. Sticked away by Stu Ashton and played forwards, but collected again by Buesa as he plays that for Stevie Moore now in the corner on the left-hand side. Back towards the middle. Abercrombie puts it wide. Rebound chance for Moore. Again goes wide off of stick check from Nick Oliver. Stevie Moore still in possession as he plays that back to the point. Another shot goes in, bobbling wide, as that's collected by Duncombe in the corner. He's pressed by Buesa, though, as a couple bounces, takes it to Nick Oliver as he cycles that around, bouncing all the way back to neutral ice, and Rick Bentham's going to chase as it's on Chris Ray's goal, and he will freeze it for a face-off.
It took a very long time for that puck to go all the way down the ice and to Ray's stick. It is a wet ice pad. It's not quite dried yet from the cut in the first interval. It's going to take a little bit longer before this ice is back up to the speed that we expect for this game. We've only had 1 minute and 42 seconds, so... Yeah.
Indeed, 18 minutes and 18 seconds left in this second period as the face-off won by the Sharks in their own end. Stevie Moore now in the corner of his own zone, plays that forwards off the skate of Buesa and now to his stick as he carries forwards over the blue line. Quick shot through bodies, rebound, score! Abercrombie ties the game up as he gets a rebound chance from Buesa's shot and tucks that past Stu Ashton.
If you're going to score a rebound goal, you've got to be in the right place at the right time. That's exactly what Abercrombie was then. Great goal from him. A little bit disappointed that that was a five-hole goal. You know, Stewie Ashton had saved that with his chest. He was already on his knees. Abercrombie came in, took the shot, and it went through Stuart Ashton underneath him. So he's going to be a little disappointed that he's let that in. 1-1, though, the score.
As this face-off after the second goal of the game is won by the Hawks. Back for Chris G, who plays it forwards for Aaron Davis. He's tied up as he fires it back into the Sharks' end. As Buesa now on this right-hand side, skating with speed into the Hawks' end. Tries to cut back, stick check, still in possession. Plays it to the middle, unable to get a shot away there as the Hawks now look to come forwards with Istocci around Miettinen. Istocci now in the circle, cuts around the net, plays it towards the middle, but no Hawks players were able to get to the spot where he put it. And now Stevie Moore in neutral zone is going to try and carry this forwards. Chris G dispossesses him, though, as it's played forwards now again for Aaron Davis. Sharks on a line change, so Aaron has plenty of ice to skate to. Gets around his man, backhand score! Through the five hole of Chris Ray, a backhand shot from Aaron Davis puts the Hawks back in the lead.
Wow, outstanding work by Aaron Davis, but I think my comment about the netminder still stands now, actually. That shouldn't have gone through him then, he should have saved that.
Yeah, very weak one let in by Chris Ray, and you can see by the look on his face, he is devastated by that one. With 17:20 left here in the second period, the Hawks take the lead once again, courtesy of what seems to be a constant goal scorer this season, number 8, Aaron Davis.
Yeah, and his testimonial season, his last season for the Hawks, and potentially his last season ever. I don't think he'll play rec hockey or go down a level after this season with the Hawks.
Yeah, in conversations with him, myself, he is basically planning to hang up his skates. As a shot comes in off the post by Fowley, gathered now by Corey Stones on the right-hand side. As he plays towards Mulcahy, that's cut out, but now a good stick check from Price as Mokai gets it back, and it's fired all the way down the far end of the ice into the Hawks' end.
There's suddenly an energy in this building. The crowd have got back behind the Hawks. They're a little bit deflated after the Solway goal. It was a good goal from the Solway Sharks, and they've been threatening to score it all game. But now that the Hawks are back in the lead, this place is buzzing.
Tied up in the Sharks' end by the Hawks, as this is pressed up with two players from either team, as the puck just comes free, but Mr. Farron had blown the whistle for a frozen puck, and we will have a face-off. As this face-off to the right of Chris Ray, it's won by the Sharks, back for Kerr, as he plays that forwards, as it's played forwards well, with a very quick back pass, and now forwards for Spears into the Hawks' end, tied up by a couple players, but gets through, shot just goes wide, as Nick Oliver is going to try and back this forward and does so, as Searman now plays that forwards for Rick Bentham, skating with speed, rides in support, tries to get the pass across, bounces off a couple players, and that'll be fired all the way down the ice by the Sharks to be collected by Nick Oliver as another panic move by them in their own end. Nick Oliver's pass misses completely though, as now Duncan Spears carries forwards, his shot off a stick and out of play.
That nearly hit the balcony behind the goal of Stuart Ashton.
It almost hit Big Chris over there.
Sorry?
It almost hit Big Chris over there.
Yeah. Of course, if people haven't been to Blackburn Arena before, there is a bar and a balcony, and that pretty much got up there. In fact, it hit it so hard, I imagine that everyone that stood on that edge got covered in dust, because, of course, it's really bad up there.
Yeah, it's not the most pleasant netting in the world.
It's better than Solihull's.
Yeah, because it's not everywhere. As this face-off won by the Hawks in their own end as they try and clear, but Stevie Moore will keep this in at the half boards. And now Buesa back towards Moore in the middle. His shot just goes off a leg and wide as that's fired forwards and out of the zone, but kept in well by Kerr. But now the Hawks get possession back again as that's fired all the way down the ice, wide of Chris Ray's goal, and will be an icing. As this face-off to the left of Stu Ashton in the Hawks' end, won by the Sharks, the Spears with another shot. Glove save by Stu Ashton as it drops behind him. Nick Oliver's tied up and battled with by Coulter as it's rang around the boards, kept in though at the point by Senko. He's going to throw it deep, gloved out of the air now by Nick Oliver as he looks to work away forwards and finds Mikko Searman on the left-hand side in the Sharks' end. Searman drops it back for Bentham. Bentham now on the right-hand side, all the way across to the middle, tipped by Nick Oliver, and a wonderful save by Chris Ray keeps this still at 2-1.
Yeah, he didn't know a lot about that save, but he made it. He was just following the puck, tracking it. His body was there, and when the shot was taken, it was only ever going to hit his leg pads.
Played behind the Hawks' goal by the Sharks as Royds has a massive hit behind him, but still keeps hold of the puck and looks to carry this forwards now as he drops it across for Bentham. As it's sticked away from him though, and now Buesa will play that forwards, and now Duncan Spears gets around his man, great little toe drag, great save on the shot by Stu Ashton, as now he gets hold of it again. Duncan Spears cuts to the middle, spins, shoots off a leg, rebound chance, and another save, Stu Ashton, who is having a lot of work to do after that save from Buesa. As this face-off to the right of Stu Ashton in the Hawks' end, is won by the Hawks as Steve Duncombe gathers and spins behind his own goal to try and work away past Buesa, does so well as now he looks to try and find a way to go forwards. Just misses out on that as it goes between his skates, but still gets the pass off for Bentham, who kicks to his stick and looks to carry. Picked off from him though, as now it's played back to the middle and Mikko Searman will gather. Royds now at his own blue line, drops it back for Nick Oliver as he plays it forwards for Duncombe. Dropped again for Bentham, can't get around Stevie Moore. And the Sharks pass goes off the mark as well, but now so does another Hawks one as Mietnan looks to carry forwards. Great stick check by Searman as now he comes forwards, tries to drop it round behind himself as now Bentham loses out as well, and the Sharks will look to clear. Stevie Moore now plays that forwards for Buesa. Buesa now into the Hawks end, cuts up at the circle, shoots, great block in front by Baldwin as that's played behind now once again for Stevie Moore. Moore now cuts out in front, shoots, pad save off the mask as it bounces again and played forwards by the Hawks, only just keeping that away from their goalie as now it's back to Mietnan in centre ice.
Yeah, there's a few times now that Stuart Ashton's put the rebound in the front of his own goal, and it's only through Solway not capitalising that they're still winning this game 2-1.
As that was attempted to be clear, gloved out the air by Spears at the blue line, his shot was a glove save by Stu Ashton as another shot goes wide just kept in at the point, not kept in at the point even by Andrews as he plays that back into the Hawks' end, but the Sharks are offside and we'll have to reset. Nick Oliver firing that through the air, off Riddick's stick and into the corner as he's going to chase. Doesn't get there first though as Andrews is ready. And now he looks to try and find a pass forward. Plays it now for Buesa. Sorry, that's Fowley. Chipped off a back as he plays that forwards and collected by Streetley as it's tipped off Istocci's stick and out of the Hawks zone. And the Sharks will have to reset once again. But it goes back to Baldwin and he plays forward now for Aaron Davis. He tries to play a pass to the middle for Riddick, but it comes now for Istocci. Goal! Joseph Istocci found himself in wide open ice in the middle after a lucky bounce and buries it to make it 3-1 Hawks.
His second goal of the night, his third of the weekend, and the best one of the lot, in my personal opinion. A one-on-one situation. I was never in any doubt that that was going to go in the back of the goal, and that's not just who the netminder is. That was a great worked play by the Hawks to get Istocci in that position, and he is a sniper from that range.
Indeed he is, and he found the corner with that one. With 3:45 left here in the second period, it is 3-1 to the Blackburn Hawks, and there's a little bit more belief in this building all of a sudden.
As I said on Friday, I didn't feel that the Hawks could get a point out of this weekend. They were playing first place, they were playing second place, and both sides have spanked the Hawks this season. It's very odd to find the Hawks in this situation where they won 2 points last night, and they're now 3-1 up against the newly crowned champions.
Stevie Moore in possession now as he carries into the Hawks end, shoots off the pad, big rebound but collected by Nick Oliver as he bounces that into the neutral zone and Kerr will have to gather. He plays that across for Senko. Senko behind his own goal, drops it back again for Kerr as the Sharks just trying to work a way out of their own zone with, it looks like they're looking for that long stretch pass they normally go for, but none of the lanes are open right now. So Senko's going to have to try and carry this. Does play a long pass through, though, that's tipped ahead by Kieran Hare. And he gets around his man, too, just at the goal line. Cuts around the goal. Can't get in front as a good pressure from Phil Mulcahy. But now Tonoi with the puck along the boards. He's pressured, but he has a man in support. As that's tied up and will be a face-off. As that's the second time the goal horn has gone where there's been no goal.
Yeah, Howard Thornton there. Just a little bit premature with his finger. This Sharks side, they're still going forward very well, but they're not getting it in front of the goal like they were. When I was talking about how Stuart Ashton was putting up a lot of rebounds, they've not done that for a while now. In fact, what's interesting is usually when they're on the counter-attack, I mean, it didn't happen in that instance, it's coming from the defence, and that's the defence are now actually sitting back because they're 3-1 behind.
As that face-off was won by the Sharks, Stevie Moore now in this left-hand corner. Now at the half boards as he skates back, drops it for Miettinen at the point. His wrist shot just tipped, but blocked by Baldwin in front as Miettinen gathers once again, but Streetley will stick that away, and that'll be carried forwards now by Royds. Sorry, no, Bentham will play that forwards, just cut out though, as now it's carried in by Andrews. His shot goes off of Baldwin's leg as a big check goes in on Andrews. Still gets away with the puck though as he carries this to the corner. Unable to handle as it's rolling along the skirting board of the ice rink, and now Baldwin will gather and play a long pass forwards for Searman. He kicks it towards his stick, just misses, and it will go back for Stevie Moore in his own end. He plays that across for Miettinen. Miettinen now with a long stretch pass, sticked out of the air by Buesa, but gathered by Streetley. Now fired forwards into the Sharks end by Bentham to be chased by Searman. Plenty of time for Miettinen though to play that across. But it's awkwardly tied up at the boards, and now Aaron Davis comes away with the puck. Aaron Davis to the middle, shoots, glove save, just bounces behind. Played out in front again as it comes now for Nick Oliver. Scores! 4-1 Hawks as Nick Oliver buries through bodies.
That was just as good a goal as last night. How that got through traffic and into the net, there was no way of saving that one. A laser beam from the edge of the blue, straight into the right-hand side of the goal.
As that face-off was won forwards by the Hawks, all the way back to neutral ice as Hutchinson had to gather. Plays forward for Spears, who throws it in. Baldwin goes off his stick, though, as it's played around now for Buesa. Buesa tries to get it to the front. Sorry, Fowley even, as now it's collected by Corey Stones. He fires that off the glass all the way across to the far side as Baldwin will try and clear. Tipped away by Carl Price, who almost had a footballer dive as he barreled over the thigh of one of the Sharks players. as now it's collected by Senko and carried forwards. He plays across now for Duncan Spears. Top of the circle, shoots, just sticks wide by Senko in front as now he gathers on the left half boards. Drops it back behind again now for Spears. Spears loses his footing though as Bobby Streetley can't quite gather and now Coulter behind the goal. Drops it back for Spears! Just about goes wide off the pad and another chance comes out in front. Hutchinson with a shot now, a big scramble in the crease. Hawks can't clear as it's played now to the left half boards, and that is the end of the second period after a huge scramble in front. So there's a big job ahead for both teams in this third period. Hawks are going to have to work very hard to keep hold of the lead they've got, and of course Solway Sharks have got a mountain to climb now.
They have and they haven't. They've certainly got the ability to win this game still, and that's the dangerous thing. The Hawks can't rest on the laurels here. You know, as I keep saying, there is a reason why this Sharks side have just won the league. And for want of a better way of putting it, there's a reason why the Hawks, as reigning champions, aren't currently in the top four. So it's all still to play for here. Again, I've said before, this ice is damp. It is very, very damp. The cut that they have here at Blackburn is quite a wet cut, so it's going to take a while for this to freeze.
As the opening face-off was won by the Sharks, Coulter now carrying it forward and firing in behind the Hawks goal as he loses his foot in there behind the goal and hammers into the boards. Rick Bentham now in possession of the puck, skating into neutral ice, drops it back towards Royce. His stick, it was lifted by Spears, but Searman collects and plays back. Now played forwards towards Royds again, missing his stick going all the way around. Collected now by Kerr. He plays forwards for Spears, who will look to try and work away forwards. He carries over the blue line into the Hawks end now on this right-hand side, into the corner. Still waiting for an option, Spears. His shot goes in off the stick of Bentham, batted out of the air, and now Mikko Searman is in behind the defence, but the defence are too quick, and they catch him, and stick lift, and get the puck back with Kim Mietnin now behind the goal.
Yeah, the way they stopped Mikko Searman taking a shot without taking a penalty, well done there for the Solway Sharks.
As Buesa throws that deep into the Hawks end, Duncombe rings that around for Bentham. He takes his time, cuts back, but now has Steve Moore pressuring him. Plays that forwards around the boards towards Istocci, kept in by the Sharks, but now back to Bentham again. He flips it over into the air for Aaron Davis to chase. Picked up by Mietnin in his own end as he fires down the ice. That'll be collected again by Bentham in his own end. Off the boards, missing the stick of Aaron Davis and Kim Mietnin, and Aaron Davis is going to chase and get there first as he gathers here in the corner, tries to get it around and does so for Istocci now behind the goal. Istocci now on this left-hand side, plays it towards the middle, sticked away by Chris Ray, collected now by Aaron Davis. He tries to get it to the middle, off the stick and collected now by Mulcahy. Mulcahy can't get his pass off properly as now it's picked up by Stevie Moore and forwards now for Buesa. Buesa into the Hawks end, just loses it off his stick as Baldwin intercepts and carries. Gets around Stevie Moore and now into the Sharks end. Tries to get around the last defenseman in front of him and can't do so as it goes off his skate. And now Buesa skating forward with speed, cuts towards the middle, chopped away from him by Istocci. As Istocci now bounces that back to neutralise to be chased by Baldwin. Collected by Kerr in his own end as he circles behind and cuts back behind his own goal. Taking his time now, playing it forward for Senko. Senko now skating with speed, cuts to the middle in the Hawks zone, shoots, scores! What a goal, seemingly out of nothing from Juraj Senko as he picks the top corner and makes it 4-2.
I think that puck was in the back of the net before it left his stick. That was ridiculous, the pace on that shot. Juraj Senko is one of the best forwards in the league, to say he's a defenseman. Reminds me of the ghost goal, as they called it, when it came up a couple of seasons ago, and it literally just went straight in the goal before the Hawks had even realised he'd taken a shot. Outstanding work from him. Again, it's 4-2. The Hawks can't rest easy on this.
As that puck is dropped for that face-off, one forwards by the Hawks, and played backwards now for Carl Price as he fires into the Sharks' end. James Riddick chasing against Senko as he plays it around for Kerr, and now played forwards for Spears. Spears all the way across towards Coulter, misses his stick and now it's collected by Carl Price. Carl Price into the middle, drops a pass for James Rinnert, can't get his shot away as it's sticked away by Spears, expertly, as he now carries behind his own goal and looks to work forwards. He plays it forwards towards Boesa, who was in behind the defence, and it was cut out and now carried by Corey Stones. His shot off a leg is picked up now by Fowley. He can't quite clear as it's held up on the ice and just now bounced out to the neutral zone and collected by Bobby Streetley. Streetley now forwards for Carl Price. He knocks it back for Kearney Witter. Kearney Witter is going to throw that deep, held in the glove of Chris Reyes. He drops it now for his defenceman to gather. Played forwards now for Boesa. A bit awkward off his skate, and now Corey Stones barrels into him and hammers him onto the ice as he still gets his pass forwards, though, but only to Rick Bentham as he gathers after being pressured by two Sharks players and will look to try and work a way forwards. His pass goes to probably the only spot of open ice out there and missed everybody as it went back to the Sharks, as now it bounces back into the Hawks' end and Kearney Witter will play forwards. Picked up now by Royds as he skates in. Just gets caught up in a bit of water, but he still gets hold of possession. Plays it towards the middle for Searman. Picked up and unable to clear of the Sharks. Searman now chopping that as it just bounces over the blue line now with Bentham. Played forwards now for Royds. Good first touch as he carries over the blue line. Still waiting for a passing option. Unable to get one as he's dispossessed by Abercrombie. He's tied up though by Bentham, and now it's played back to the point for Duncombe. His shot goes off a stick and into the far corner for Searman. Searman now back for Nick Oliver. He throws it deep now for Royds. But Royce doesn't get it. Bentham does as it's played to the middle. As Royce takes a quick shot, now held by Bentham behind as that went wide. He carries round into the corner. Back to Duncombe from the point. Big pad save. It's still rolling around. Searman had no idea where it was as it was between his legs. Back to the point again. Nick Oliver with a shot blocked by Stevie Moore. Now held at the boards near the blue line. Two Sharks pressuring him as it's just cleared back to neutral ice. And Steve Duncombe will gather. Fans on his first attempt to pass across, but still carries, being chased by Boesa. He now circles that round for Nick Oliver. Oliver tries to fire that down for Mikko Searman and finds him well as he gets into the Sharks' end. Gets around two Sharks players into the corner, tries to get it for Bentham as it's cut out by Spears, and now he plays forward for Fowley. Fowley's chopped away from him expertly by Baldwin at the blue line and now played forwards. Kerr now playing back all the way for Senko. Great pace to this period so far with 14:25 left in the third, as Senko now behind his goal will look to try and work away forwards, and does so as he plays it across to the left wing. Carrying now in as it's pressed against the boards by Chris G and collected behind, as now it is Spears and now for Colton. Back for Spears in front, cuts back, shoots as the net was knocked off, and it wouldn't have been a goal if it went in. 10 minutes 49 left here in this third period. The face-off to the left of Chris Reyes, won by the Sharks. As that's carried around now, played forwards towards Coulter, off the boards, all the way down the ice. No icing as that's waved off. Gathered now by Nick Oliver. Nick Oliver plays a long pass for Searman. He drops it towards Bentham, just unlucky on the bounce, as it's gathered now by Spears. Spears now cuts to the middle. Big check on him by Streetley, and Nick Oliver grabs. He'll play that across forwards now for Bentham. Now a big long pass all the way across for Searman. Searman behind the goal, still looking for an option. Plays it out in front, unable to get to anyone before Bentham cuts across and grabs it. He plays a long pass across towards Duncombe. Duncombe just loses out as his skate falls from under him, and it looks like he's hurt himself doing that as well, as now Spears comes forward with Coulter in support. Nick Oliver in the middle. Spears plays it across through the legs and just off the skate of Coulter into the corner as no shot was taken. Spears still with possession, but now it comes to Searman. He lofts that out as Mietnen tries to glove it out the air, bounces off of his hand and into the ice, as now it's played forwards for Stevie Moore. Moore now on this right-hand side, drops it back for Mietnen with a quick shot, tipped away by Baldwin into the corner as it's gathered now by Stevie Moore. Picked up now by Istocci as he looks to try and find a way out. Good power move by Istocci to keep the puck, using his body to keep the player away, as now he gets it to Baldwin. Now across towards Chris G, he can't quite handle as Aaron Davis smacks that down the ice for Istocci to chase, and he will get there first as he gets a stick on it, brings it out in front, backhand score! Joseph Istocci closes off the hat-trick and makes it 5-2 Hawks!
He beat the icing, he raced all the way down into the corner, he was the first man there, he brought it back out and he put it in the back of the goal, 5-hole yet again, a well-deserved hat-trick.
7:29 now left on the clock as the Sharks win that in their own end. Forwards now for Spears. Spears skates into the neutral zone, plays it forwards for Stevie Moore. Cut out now by Nick Oliver, and he plays it forwards for Mikko Searman. Seaman now into the Sharks' end, drops it back for Mulcahy. Mulcahy tries to get it to the middle, sticked away and now gathered by Spears. Spears skating forwards through the middle of the neutral zone, cuts now to the right into the Sharks' end. Can't get around Nick Oliver, as a great stick check from him. Bounces that off the boards and that will get to neutralise now for Senko. His stick's lifted, but he still keeps hold of it as he throws that deep all the way into the Hawks' end. And it actually hits the skirting board and sits perfectly still behind the goal before being gathered and now played forwards for Bobby Streetley. Streetley now able to skate forwards into space as the Sharks man lost his footing, and it's played to the middle, cut out by Senko. Senko now skating forwards over the blue line, dropped across for Coulter. Coulter all the way to the middle, rebound, score! Stevie Moore makes it 5-3 on a rebound chance that was just about tipped, and he found the gap.
This is the game of the five hole, isn't it? Another one that went underneath Stuart Ashton there, between his legs. He couldn't drop quick enough for Stevie Moore being in the slot. Great work by the Sharks, yet again, the good going forwards. And Stevie Moore is an outstanding player, as we know. Giving him that chance in the slot, you know, nine times out of ten he'll put it in the back, and that's what he's done there. Still a two-goal game now with only 6:33 to go.
Indeed, not a lot of time left here in the third period as the Sharks cut another goal off of that lead once again. As that face-off is tied up in the middle and won eventually by the Sharks, back to Kim Mietnen now as he throws that deep. That'll be chased by Buesa and Baldwin. And Buesa gets there and tries to throw it behind the goal. Ends up ringing all the way around, will be gathered by Baldwin. Baldwin now to the middle, plays a long stretch pass all the way across for Aaron Davis. Aaron Davis now cuts the middle, drops it for Bentham, back to Aaron Davis, score! Aaron Davis extends the lead back to three with a great 1-2 pass work with Rick Bentham.
I thought he'd done a little bit too much there. That was some good 1-2 play. I thought that maybe they'd done a little bit. They passed it that once too many times. Fortunately, that pulled Ray out of position and Aaron Davis could put that in the back of the goal.
That face-off won by the Hawks, back to neutralise. They just back that into the Sharks' end, 200 feet away from their own goal. Senko will gather that and carry forwards. He gets over his own blue line around Carl Price, skates with good intent, gets all the way through, shoots, great save, Stu Ashton, picked up by Carl Price. He fans on his first clear, still gathers as there's only 6 seconds left. Played forwards, back to neutral ice, and that will be the end of the game. An unbelievable Blackburn Hawks performance has the entire building on their feet. A rousing applause for a 6-3 victory for the Hawks that just about keeps their playoff opportunity alive.
Well, we promised you goals.
we always pick the good games, Gary, don't we?
And they haven't let us down. Blackburn have got to be well pleased with that result tonight. They've taken two wins off the number one spot and the number two spot.
Well, we told you at the beginning of the show, guy to watch out for, and he certainly showed it tonight. Estocci, what a hat-trick, you know what I mean? Really well earned.
Aaron Davis, of course, getting two, and that third one by Nick Oliver. 6-3 winners, I mean, over Solway. That's an impressive result. I'm sure Solway would be licking their wounds after that one, but Blackburn got to be happy going into the next game with that.
Well, that's it now. They've got to be looking towards the playoffs here. They're going to want that fourth place. Yeah, it's only time will tell, but they've got the contention to do it. They've got the form to do it. Let's hope they can carry on.
Well, they've got some tough games coming up. Yeah, they've got to play the Solihull Barons twice. They've also got to play Solway again. And don't forget, there's still that remaining game that was cancelled earlier in the season. They've got to play against the Dragons, and we know the Dragons can be a tough team.
Yeah, certainly, and it's going to be one to watch out for.
So, thanks for joining us. Catch us for all the NIHL action here on Drop the Puck.